welcome to this, our Monday, November 4, 2019 edition of News Update. I'm Sandy Ramutar. For us, the top stories we're tracking this evening. Heighten your activism, return home and vote in March 2020, Jagdeo tells large gathering of Guyanese in Canada. Cheekham staff accused of turning away persons from registration offices. Businessman shoots bandit during home invasion as crime continues to spiral. 17 murders in just 2 weeks, but top cop unbothered about crime situation. And in sport, West Indies not taking Afghanistan lightly ahead of first ODI on Wednesday. These and more coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Are you running out of ideas of what gift to buy? Scared of getting the wrong size or color or something they already have? Why not try a gift certificate from John Lewis Styles? Available in any dollar value and can be used towards clothing, shoes, and accessories. Let the person choose exactly what they want and they'll definitely be happy. Gift certificates can also be used as employee bonuses, sales incentives, and office gift exchanges. So try our gift certificates today. John Lewis Styles, simply different.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
You know, since me find out about Tire Future Shop, me house look nicer than you one. My credit rate, how you can afford to buy all them things?
I'm going to tell you.
Now me not going to catch again our secret.
No, come on, man. A magic, you're too fast. Mind the business.
Excuse me, uncle, tell me something. How credit can afford to buy so much thing from I only now walk no way?
It's because now we introduce our new discount card.
Apply now for your discount card at Tayo Future Shop. Every time you shop using your discount card, your percentage increases. Start from 5% off. Your next purchase, 7% off. Then 10% off, etc. Until you start getting wholesale and factory price. Check in store for more details. Conditions apply.
Help me get me Tayo discount card.
Wait, man. What you gotta do next, man? Buy the whole entire store?
Welcome back. Now for the news in detail. As the election season heats up, People's Progressive Party civic presidential candidate Dr. Irfan Ali says good governance practiced by the PPPC for its 24 years in office will ensure the party win the March 2020 elections.
With March 2020 fast approaching, all parties vying for presidency are continuing their groundwork. During an interview with the newsroom, presidential candidate of the PPPC, Irfan Ali, said his party practiced prudent governance, reason for them being in office for over two decades. Social justice, good and inclusionary governance must be some of the pillars of Guyana's economy, Ali affirmed.
We are looking at building a Guyana that is free, globally competitive, one that offers equitable opportunity.
Ali also noted that the PPPC in office will ensure all sectors are bolstered, especially the health, education, and infrastructure sectors.
Quality healthcare, better quality education, and one that would build on infrastructure, not only looking at economic growth, but looking also at social development, looking at the human side.
Meanwhile, the People's National Congress Reform, PNCR, has been making similar statements. The party claimed it has been practicing inclusionary governance as seven different political parties make up the government of the day. The election to determine which party will preside over Guyana and the oil and gas sector will be on March 2, 2020. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo on the weekend encouraged overseas-based Guyanese to heighten their activism as Guyana prepares for general and regional elections on March 2, 2020. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo has urged Guyanese abroad to return home to cast their ballots on March 2, 2020. Jagdeo was at the time addressing a fundraising event organized by the Association of Concerned Guyanese in Toronto, Canada. His call comes at a time when the commission intends to remove at least 20,000 names from the National Register because persons were still to uplift their national identification cards dating back to 2008.
That you can help. You can help by coming home to vote. You can help, like how you're doing here financially, to, by doing this. Our campaign has been a long one. I'm not good at raising finances and stuff, but our campaign has been a long one. You can help online, even if you don't have any resource, but go online, get involved, share our views, what we stand for, get to understand what we stand for us and cheer them.
The party has made it clear that it will not allow the Elections Commission to disenfranchise persons from the National Register of Registrants. The names will be published in newspapers and notices will be sent to their addresses, giving them 21 days within which to collect their identification cards. Failure to adhere and respond will prevent those persons from voting. The People's Progressive Party has reportedly received complaints from a number of persons who were turned away from the Guyana Elections Commission registration centers. The People's Progressive Party has indicated that it has received reports that persons who turn up to register at the Guyana Elections Commission registration centers are being turned away. Persons were reportedly told that they cannot re-register because their names are on a list compiled with the data garnered from the suspended house-to-house registration. Public Relations Officer Yolanda Ward has assured that the data garnered from the suspended house-to-house registration will be used. But while Yard is giving this assurance, there is no word from the commission itself or its chairperson, retired Justice Scott Singh, on how it intends to use the data from the registration. As a matter of fact, Commissioner Robson Ben, speaking on a televised program last evening, said that the data cannot be used as it is rife with errors.
As an eligible elector, you have the right to go and insist that your name be placed on the list via claim or an objection for removal or whatever in respect of the elections and getting on the list.
Claims ended today and many persons are fearful that they may be left off the official list of electors since they were unable to register during the claims and objections period. Objections will remain until November 12, 2019. The coalition's claim of the voters' list being bloated by over 200,000 names has been dismantled, as there has been only 500 objections at the end of the penultimate day for claims. Our senior reporter Godfrey Brooms in this analysis piece examined the official voters' list for the 2011 and 2015 elections and found that the number of votes cast compared with the size of the voters' list for these elections also disproved the claim of the coalition. Let's take a look.
The coalition's rationale for house-to-house registration was due to the voters' list being heavily bloated. The coalition repetitively parroted that the list had over 200 persons that should not be there. The house-to-house registration was later cut short, and a claims and objections period was held, which concluded today. But, as of November 3, 2019, only 500 objections were made, which questions the validity of the claim of the list being bloated by over 200,000 names. An analysis of the election's data shows that in 2006, there were 492,369 registered voters, while only 336,375 voted. 155,994 did not vote, representing a 69% voter participation. In 2011, 475,496 persons were registered, but only 342,126 votes were cast. This means 133,370 persons eligible to vote did not. Voter participation was 73%. In 2015, there were 570,708 registered voters. Of that figure, 412,012 votes were cast. 158,696 persons did not vote. This shows a 72% voter turnout. From the last three elections in Guyana, the average voter participation is 71.3%. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Instead of closing sugar estates and creating an economic and social vacuum, a fact-based approach that included impact studies should have been pursued by the government. This view was expressed by opposition leader Bart Jagdeo as he addressed the packed hall during an elections campaign event in Canada at the weekend. Jagdeo told members of the Association of Concerned Guyanese at a dinner in Toronto, Canada, that sugar needed transitional help, but indicated that the government's approach was anything but transitional. While he acknowledged that some from the party's rural agriculture base were led astray by false promises from the coalition at the last elections, Jagdeo was confident that any votes from the sugar belt that the party lost in 2015 have returned to the PPPC. Jagdeo recalled that it was President David Granger himself who said he would be guided by a commission of inquiry and spend $70 million in order to establish one. Despite all of that, the COI findings was disregarded. Back in 2017, the government had announced plans to close the Enmore and Rose Hall sugar estates, sell the Skeldon Sugar Factory, reduce the annual production of sugar, and take on the responsibility of managing the drainage irrigation services offered by the Ghana Sugar Corporation. Subsequently, in November of that year, Gaisuku announced plans to retrench 2,500 workers by the end of that year. Amid much criticism, over 7,000 were retrenched, with some having to fight for the severance they were legally entitled to. The government, following this, hatched plans to privatize the assets of the sugar company, but that plan was stalled after the coalition was toppled by a no-confidence motion last December. Still ahead, businessman shoots bandit during home invasion as crime continues to spiral. 17 murders in just 2 weeks, but Top Cop unbothered about crime situation. And in sport, West Indies not taking Afghanistan lightly ahead of first ODI on Wednesday. These and more when we return. Stay with us.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at 5 and 10, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot
like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will
jithe vi tu chalna hai mahi main tere piche piche chalna tu ji sakdi nahi main ji sakda nahi koi dusri main shartaan vi rakhda nahi kya tere baajo mera sachiyan mohabbat aave wahi kitte aur nahi milna.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet presenting Coleomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coleomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coleomac. Only at the SlimJet, City Mall, second floor.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
BM South Auto Sales presents Vehicle Leasing. Trade in. In with the old, out with the new. Low down payment deals as low as 500,000. Duty-free deals for anyone with a duty-free concession. 5% cash back. Buy any vehicle cash and get 5% off instantly. Visit our showroom for more info or call 231-8451 or visit our Facebook page, BM South Auto Sales.
Using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Welcome back, you're watching MTV's News Update. As crime continues to spiral out of control, Karanjeet Burbi's family is now left traumatized after about six gun-toting bandits attempted to break into their home but were warded off after an occupant of the house opened fire on the men. Reports are that early this morning, armed bandits were discovered breaking into the home of Goriel Balram at number 69 Village, Quarantine. Balram reported that he heard a loud banging on the wall and discovered that the men had already broken a hole into the wall and were attempting to gain entry. Balram, who is a licensed firearm holder, reportedly attempted to thwart their effort by firing three shots at the men, but they returned fire. The armed men gained entry into the home, but before they could have attacked the family, they realized that one of theirs was injured and quickly made good their escape. Police investigations are still ongoing. Former Attorney General Anil Nandlal today chided chairman of GCOM for deciding to remove names from the official list of electors if they fail to collect their identification cards. The enforcement of this decision will cause the disenfranchisement of 20,000 odd Guyanese.
Former Attorney General Anil Nandlal made it clear that there is no nexus between the possession of an ID card and the right to vote. under the laws of Guyana, nothing prevents a person who is on the voters list to have an ID card to cast their ballot. This was recently reinforced by the decision of the Chief Justice when she ruled that having an ID card is not a prerequisite for voting. However, Chairman of the Guyana Elections Commission, retired Justice Claudette Singh, last week decided that persons will be removed from the official list of electors if they fail to collect their ID card. ID cards that haven't been collected since 2008. But Nandlal said if that decision is implemented, it will cause widespread disenfranchisement. He said too it is likely to result in the impending elections being declared null and void and wholly set aside by the court, moved by an election petition. Meanwhile, the People's National Congress Reform, the largest party in government, fully supports the removal of names. The party claims that 28,000 odd names are phantoms placed on the list by the previous government to secure votes at elections. The PNCR said, were the persons real, they would have collected their ID cards over a decade ago. Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
As Guyanese prepare to celebrate Christmas, fears are that there could be another shortage of chicken, which could see the already high prices skyrocketing. Today, we spoke to a number of producers and wholesalers who are confident adequate supplies will be on the market, but some poultry vendors are of a different view.
With the holiday season fastly approaching, retailers and wholesalers of poultry are in a preparatory mood in ensuring there is adequate supply in the market. On a visit to several poultry distributors in the city, this newscast was informed that there will likely be no shortage or spike in the price for poultry during the holiday season. Proprietor of Fish Hook Meat Center, Mohamed Muche, related his optimism in there being an improvement in the availability of chicken at reasonable costs.
Well, I think the chicken is coming back on stream. I do not anticipate a rise in the price. We hope that come this holiday, we should have enough chickens based on what I'm seeing. And I do not anticipate a rise in the price. I think it will remain constant.
As a retail price?
Retail price right now is $400 a pound. Right, the wholesale price is like about 360 thereabout. That's what we are selling for. But if the price goes down, then we certainly will be able to bring the price down.
Meanwhile, proprietor of Padarak Poultry Depot and Plucking Center, Padmini Saw, related while the price of chicken may fluctuate during the year, at present the availability and the price for the produce remain stable.
For instance, if the chickens would like. It would fluctuate between 360 and 380. It wouldn't even touch $400. I'm sure, guarantee that.
Meanwhile, poultry vendor Kevin said based on the current availability of the meat, he is concerned that there will be a shortage for the holiday season.
But the chicken shot now, but I like but the chicken shot about 4 months to 5 months now. Right now it looks like it's a shot for reality.
In July, the Ghana Livestock Development Authority confirmed that there was a shortage of chicken meat for consumption on the local market. It attributed the shortage to the reduction of hatching eggs imported as of June this year. The Ghana Poultry Producers Association, however, said that the shortage earlier in the year was as a result of authorities clamping down on the large-scale smuggling of the meat product from neighboring Suriname. Reporting for MTV News Update, LaShawna Gomes, Cornelius.
We tell you now that Guyana has recorded some 17 murders in the past 2 weeks as crime continues to spiral, but Commissioner of Police Leslie James said he's unbothered by the crime situation that has enveloped the country. According to reports, on October 12, four fishermen were robbed, killed and thrown overboard. The following day, October 13, 32-year-old Jackson Bowen's body was found with marks of violence in front of the office of the leader of the opposition in Church Street. On October 14, popular businessman, 44-year-old Dion Stott, Inc., also known as Mao, was fatally gunned down during an attempted robbery in front of Eldorado Trading in Kitty, Georgetown. While later that day, an 18-year-old Ghana Defense Force ranked Elijah Chesney was found dead in Tuckville. His body bore gunshot wounds. The next day, 59-year-old Gregory Adolphus, a number 8 West Coast Burmese man, was shot and killed by suspected bandits. On October 20, Noel Rampersad, aged 22 years old, was stabbed to death at Metamir Resort, West Coast, Demerara. The following day, October 21, the partially decomposed body of Abdul Ghani was found at Potentia, West Bank, Demerara. On October 22, Doman Nandalal was murdered at Unity Village, East Coast, Demerara. October 25, 14-year-old Christopher Bastia was found in a shallow grave at La Parfait Harmony, West Bank, Demerara. Further, a 28-year-old Venezuelan national, Valentina Mariles Pateo, died while trying to save her boyfriend from being shot. They came under gunfire from the men in the river. That same day, a 48-year-old Transport and Harbor Department sailor was stabbed to death at the Perica Selling. He was identified as Sherling Cutting. November 1, a burned car was found at Letter T. Myconi, where a body was found in the trunk of the vehicle. The charred body is suspected to be that of Colin Rodney, a star witness in an ongoing murder case. On November 2, a 40-year-old farmer was killed at a bar at Myconi. He was identified as David Meacher. The latest murder was committed on Sunday at Rupununi Region 9, where 18-year-old Dallin Francis at Rapperty was found in a pool of blood on his birthday. But Commissioner James told reporters on Friday that the crimes are considered as petty crimes and added that he's not too bothered by these few sensational crimes. But while James and Public Security Minister Kamra Dramjitan have downplayed a high level of crime in the country, recently the United States issued a travel advisory to its citizens journeying to Ghana, citing the spiraling of crime here. Residents of West Barbados and West Demerara are still reeling from the effects of last week's high tides, which left their homes flooded and destroyed their crops, and there was no help in sight from central government. This was the information relayed to this newscast when we spoke to regional officials in Regions 3 and 5 today.
Region 3 Chairman Julius Faber is concerned over the state of several villages, as some of them are still affected due to the recent overtopping. Faber, via telephone, expressed the disappointment over the approach of the regional administration body in ensuring that severely clogged up drains are cleared. Faber asserted since the overtopping, many of the affected communities have not received any intervention from the administration.
They did. Mm-hmm. They were able to get some assistance from the region and from NDIA. And so the communities that are pro-Indo-Guyanese, those communities have not been cleaned or cleared. And that is what happened. You have these people, they're working on areas that are related to their control. Mm-hmm. And so the other areas that is not under their control, for example, dominated by their people, they do not clean those areas. They are not working in the interest of all the people in the region.
Between October 25th and 30th, parts of the country's low-lying coastal plains of Essequibo Islands, West Demerara, and Mahaika Berbice regions experienced bouts of overtopping due to an unusually high spring tide. While noting that those affected were able to get some assistance from the National Drainage and Irrigation Authority, Faber noted in the long run, a more proactive approach by the administration is needed to protect those overtopping-prone locations from flooding. Meanwhile, Region 5 Chairman Vic Chand Ramphal voicing similar concerns since the recent sea defense breach at Danzig and overtopping, says many families, including cash crop and livestock farmers, have been greatly affected. Ramphal noted, in light of the predicament, no meaningful assistance has been afforded to those individuals.
And many of them, you know, they are uncertain about how they will continue with their livelihood and their farming. The drainage, it remains the same. Most of the land in the area are still under salt water. I understand that the NDIA will be constructing a dam, a temporary embankment to block the water from coming in inland. But for the other areas that are affected, it still remains the same.
Ramphal posited about 25,000 acres of farmland located near the Danzig area depend heavily on drainage. Areas likely to be further affected once the rains become constant are Little Bible, No. 10, De Hoop, and Mahikoni, Ramphal noted. Caretaker Minister of Agriculture Noel Holder, via telephone, indicated that assistance have been given to those affected in the region. Holder also noted that efforts to reinforce the sea defense at Danzig have already begun with much urgency.
We have been there giving them all kind of assistance. We as ministry have done a lot. You got in there, you've given them, you know, hampers. We've, you know, currently we're doing the dam right now to ensure that putting a separate dam that the high tides wouldn't continue to affect.
However, when contacted today, a number of residents from the affected communities deny Holder's claims, stating that they have not received any tangible assistance from the government. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Four armed bandits on Saturday evening robbed a supermarket of cash and other valuables before escaping. The supermarket, which is located at No. 2 East Kanji Burbese, is operated by Chinese. iNews reported two of the bandits were armed with guns and two with cutlasses. The men demanded that the Chinese hand over the money in the cash register. After a bit of hesitation by the owner, one of the bandits went to the cash register himself and emptied it. Investigators were told that some $300,000 and two cellular phones were taken. The police are continuing the probe. Back in October 2017, the said supermarket was robbed by bandits. Here is Celine Griffith with MTV's Court Roundup.
A 29-year-old man who was allegedly caught with an illegal gun along with matching ammunition was today sentenced when he appeared before Magistrate Cheryl Isaacs Marcus at the Georgetown Magistrates Courts. Kevin Bruce called bank. He confessed that on September 26, 2019, at Easel Penitence, Georgetown, he had in his possession a .32 pistol and 10 matching ammunition while not being the holder of a firearm license. According to the prosecution's facts, ranks from the Easel Penitence Police Station were summoned to a location after someone called the police and informed them that an unknown male was in a yard. As the ranks entered the yard, they saw Bruce exiting the southern door of a house with a haversack on his back. When the ranks called out to Bruce, he began to run, and this resulted in a foot chase. He was subsequently apprehended and a search was carried out on him, but nothing was found. However, while at the police station, ranks observed him placing his hands in his crotch and taking out a handgun. This resulted in the rank drawing his service weapon and discharging a round, which hit the defendant to his abdomen. Kevin Bruce was today sentenced to a total of 4 years, 2 years on each of the charges. However, the sentences will run concurrently, which means he will only spend 2 years in prison. In another matter, a man was today placed before the court to answer to a break and enter and larceny charge. 42-year-old Selwyn Jackman, called Dingo, pleaded guilty to the charge which read that between the 28th and 29th of October at Festival City, Northumveld, he broke and entered the dwelling house of Andrew Richardson and stole therein a quantity of amplifiers and car parts, reaching the total value of $31,200. According to reports, the parties are known to each other. On the day in question, the virtual complainant returned home from work and discovered that the items were missing. He then viewed CCTV footage which showed the defendant accessing the house and removing the items. The matter was reported and Jackman was arrested and charged with the present offense. Selwyn Jackman was sentenced to 2.5 years in prison for the offense. Finally, a teen was today hauled before Magistrate Cheryl Isaacs Marcus to answer to an armed robbery charge. Shannon Joseph, 18, of Law 26D Field Turkine Sophia, denied the charge which alleged that on October 12 at Charlotte and Arnock Streets, while being armed with a knife, he robbed Kennedy Singh of a cell phone valued $35,000 and $25,000 cash. According to reports, on the day in question, the defendant approached a virtual complainant on a bicycle asking for directions. After the man gave him the directions, he allegedly pulled out a knife and relieved the man of the items mentioned in the charge. On November 2, the defendant went to the location where the offense occurred in search of a job. This was when the victim, who worked at the same business place, was able to positively identify him and inform the police. As such, Joseph was arrested and subsequently charged. Police prosecutor Quinn Harris objected to bail, citing the fact that the defendant gave the police a different address than the one he gave in court, as well as the fact that a knife was used during the robbery and the victim being able to positively identify him. As such, bail was refused and Shannon Joseph was remanded to prison until November 18. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
We now join Rajesh Lakhan with Sar Computer's Tech Wrap.
Good evening and welcome to this week's edition of the Star Technology Wrap. I'm your host Rajesh Lakhan, and after a long time we have with us Yannick Sobers, and this week we'll be touching on Hikvision surveillance security cameras. Tell us about it.
Alright, Rajesh, so this week, as you said, we're talking about Hikvision, and you know at Star Computers we're always about, you know, great brands, great products, and Hikvision is no different. You know, it's a really, really cool brand when it comes to cameras and surveillance systems, and right now we have a wide variety of Hikvision cameras, DVRs, whatever you need, you know, to set up your surveillance system. We've decided to, you know, go really, really big when it comes to the Hikvision brand, because we believe in it, and anything we believe in at Star Computers, we basically, we push the brand, you know, like our previous brands like Lenovo, HP and so on, and we are the authorized distributor of Hikvision right now in Guyana. So if you're looking for your Hikvision cameras, DVRs, you know, we have them here available for you, and we have great after sales service. You know, we also have persons that can help you to analyze your system and your needs. You know, we have quality professionals here to help you do that.
Yannick, you mentioned a wide variety of Hikvision cameras. Take us through them, man.
Okay, so in terms of the cameras, we have HD cameras starting from 720p all the way to 1080p. And if you're thinking pixels, we also have 5 megapixels and 8 megapixels. So great quality when you're talking about cameras there. In terms of DVRs and NVRs, we have a wide variety also. We have from 4 channels all the way up to 64 channels. So if you have a large organization, you know, maybe let's say like with the recent oil boom that we have, you know, large companies, offshore places, and they have a lot of cameras that they would need, this is a great opportunity to, you know, use the Hikvision brand, and they give you excellent quality, as I said.
Briefly take us through these cameras you have on display.
Okay, so for a home setup, I would recommend one of the HD cameras here. This one here, it has a 1080p pixel, and it's a really, really good rating. You get good night vision, nice wide angle, and so on. So perfect for a home use. If you're thinking of something more in the lines of, let's say, a business, you can go with one of these guys. These can go with 5 megapixels, even 8 megapixels. So good quality, because you know you have a lot more foot traffic at a business than at home. So yeah.
Yannick, in terms of description, I'm seeing the dome camera along with the bullet. Yes. How about the 360 degrees?
Yes, we also do have the 360 degrees camera, which is called the pan, tilt, and zoom. That allows you to basically pan. You can tilt it up and down, rotate 360 degrees. Perfect for outdoor events or, you know, basically that.
Great. In terms of installation, do you guys have technicians to assist customers?
We do have technicians that we normally work with that we can put you on to, so work with you. Yeah.
Great. Aside from the cameras, what else happened here?
Well, as always, you know, Star Computers, we always have great prices, great products available here, so you can check us out, check out our showroom. Don't forget to visit our kids section also upstairs, the Innovation Center. And thank you once again for joining us.
Well, thank you, Yannick. It's great having you back on the Tech Wrap, man.
Yes.
And that's all we have for you in this week's edition of Star Technology Wrap. Do join us next week, Monday, for another edition.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
Turn your houses into homes at zenafurniture.gy, 249 Orinoco and Foreshore Streets, Georgetown. Telephone number 227-6609. Check us out for a wide variety of furniture for every part of your home. Get uniquely designed and high-quality bedroom sets, living room sets, dining room sets, entertainment sets, outdoor and kids' furniture, all at unbeatable prices. There is also a wide variety of lamps, mirrors, and other items to accessorize your home. All furniture imported from USA. Purchase a bedroom set and receive a lamp free. Zenafurniture.gy, adding a touch of comfort to your life.
Enter the GBTI Quick Cash Christmas promotion and make it a Christmas to remember. you get up to $500,000 easy for anything you want this Christmas. Plus, enter for a chance to win fabulous items for your home. One complete 7-foot granite top base kitchen cabinet, one sectional suite, one 5-piece dinette set, and complimentary baskets of goodies. Apply at your nearest branch or online at www.gbtibank.com. GBTI, we see Christmas through your eyes.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
80% of the population around the world have stomachal problems because the water is contaminated. Some of these stomachal problems are diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, filaria. Avoid this sickness with the latest water purifier. Drink clean, fresh mineral water at all the time. Just put water from the pipe, the river, or rainwater at the top of the water purifier, and the system is going to remove all the impurities. Easy to use, easy to sample, no current, no batteries. Purify more than 10,000 liters of water.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
The Guyana Elections Commission would be conducting a claims and objections exercise from the 1st of October 2019. Persons have until the 4th of November 2019 to make a claim to be on the list if you will be 18 years or older by the 31st of December 2019, a Guyanese citizen by birth, descent, naturalization, or registration, a citizen of a Commonwealth country living in Guyana for a period of no less than 1 year preceding the 31st of December 2019, persons who require changes or corrections to their particulars as stated on the preliminary list of electors, such as names, occupations, and transfers in relation to their addresses, can also do same during the claims and objections period. You must present the relevant original documents in order for the transaction to be completed. Don't delay. Visit the nearest GCAM registration office today. For more information, visit our website at www.gcam.org.gy. Follow GCAM on Facebook at Guyana Elections Commission. Contact us on 225-0277-9 or 223-9653. Email pro@gcam.org.gy or the nearest GCAM registration office.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International Trucks and Parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand. SKF Bearings and Mounted Products. NAPA Batteries. Tide Power Generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. West Indies skipper Kieran Pollard has insisted it will be important for the team to carefully plan their approach against the potent threat posed by the Afghanistan spinners on Wednesday.
The Windies will face the Afghans, led by Rashid Khan, in 3 one-day internationals and 3 T20 internationals. Despite being ranked just above the hosts in the ICC ODI standings, the Afghans hold an advantage after winning 3 of the last 6 encounters. The Asian team has often taken advantage of the Windies' noted weakness against spin bowling, a fact not lost on the Windies skipper. Pollard mentioned the Windies as a team have to plan how they are going to structure their 50 overs of batting and their 50 overs of bowling. He added, each and every one of the players will show what they have to offer when the series bowls off on Wednesday in Afghanistan. Immediately after, they will kick-start the T20 series before facing the hosts in a one-off test on November 27. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV's Sports Update.
India's women leveled a three-match one international series of the ongoing Colonial Medical Insurance Women's Super 50 after defeating the West Indies women by 53 runs in match two.
India won the toss and elected to bat first. The Windies' bowlers got off to a thrilling start, eliminating India's Jemima Rodrigues for zero. Not too long after, Guyana's Shabika Gajanabi dismissed Priya Punaya for five. Poonam Roth and captain Mithali Raj consolidated the India middle order, posting a 66-run partnership to give life to the Indian lineup before Raj was caught off Shanita Grimmon for 40. Later, India finished their 50 overs on 191 for 6. Afi Fletcher was the most successful West Indies bowler, taking 2 for 32, followed by Alia Allen with 2 for 38. The West Indies batters were unsettled as the Indian side got off to a nerve-wracking start. Shemaine Campbell and captain Stephanie Taylor top-scored with 39 and 20 respectively after Natasha McLean retired on 15. Alia Allen fought valiantly in the end with a 16 to show some resistance against the Indians before falling in the 48th over. The third and final ODI bowls off on Wednesday in Antigua from 9 hours 30. Brittany Cooper was ruled out of the remainder of the series following a bruised shin after being struck with a ball and will be replaced by Kenesha Isaac. Also ruled out is Chanel Henry, who suffered a concussion after crashing head-first into the boundary board after saving two runs. She will be replaced by returning Hayley Matthews. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV's Sports Update.
Guyana Jaguars Kimo Savery acquired assistance from VNet Communications ahead of his departure from Guyana earlier today for the Colonial Medical Insurance Regional Super 50 in Trinidad and Tobago, and St. Kitts set to bowl off on Wednesday. Guyana, hunting a regional Super 50 title since 2005, will be playing in Group B in Trinidad. Their first match is on November 7 against West Indies Emerging Players Squad at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. Trinidad and Tobago Red Force, Windward Islands Volcanoes, and the United States of America are the other teams in the group. Teams will play a double-round-robin format with the two topped progressing to the semifinals. The squad reads Tej Narayan Chanjapal, Chanjapal Hemraj, Leon Johnson captain, Christopher Barnwell, Raymond Rifer, Anthony Bramble, Goody Cage Moti, Versami Pramal, Clinton Pestano, Ronsford Beaton, Niall Smith, Jonathan Fu, Kimo Savery, and Ramal Lewis. Former FIFA referee Otis James was elected as president of the Georgetown Football Association following an extraordinary general meeting yesterday.
The meeting was held to address the continued lack of activity and non-functional executive committee in the GFA over the past 3 years. This lack of activity prompted parent body, the Guyana Football Federation, to intervene to ensure that the administrative arm of the game in the city became functional again. Members present at the extraordinary general meeting were the Georgetown Football Club, Beacon Football Club, Northern Rangers, Camp Town, Black Pearl, East Rhymeville United, Pile, GT Panthers Rhythm Squad, Wolves United, and Order and Discipline. Conducting yesterday's election was the Guyana Football Federation's Electoral Committee, and James, in his first speech as president, expressed thanks to the GFF and disclosed within the next 3 months, work will be seen as all heads and hands will work together for one cause, football. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV's Sports Update.
Four-time Grand Slam champion Kim Clijsters have delayed her WTA Tour comeback because of a knee injury. Clijsters, 36, says she will not be able to compete in January as she continues rehabilitation and treatment. Clijsters, who first retired in 2007 to start a family, says she has been inspired by other mothers such as Serena Williams and Victoria Azarenka. The former world number one returned in 2009 and won three more Grand Slams before her second retirement in 2012. When her latest return was announced in September, Clijsters said she was targeting a return in January when the 2020 season starts, but added she would remain flexible in her scheduling. The Guyana Table Tennis Association has acquired ITTF Level 1 Cuban coach Osdani Romario Garcia for 2 months to work with local table tennis players.
Osdani is excellently experienced, especially in Venezuela, and recently leading Caribbean women's champion Daniela Fonseca to victory. Head of the Guyana Table Tennis Association, Godfrey Monroe, disclosed Osdani is an ITTF Level 1 coach, adding it is the GTTA's prerogative that Osdani works with the local players. It was further mentioned that Osdani will be involved in 2 training sessions with the local players per week at the Cliff Anderson Sports Hall. He will also provide assistance to ITTF coach Candice McKenzie with the school's pathway project. Following the conclusion of Osdani's stint, he will provide a report and a recommendation to the GTTA. Chelsea Lee, report of MTV's Sports Update.
Lewis Hamilton said he was flying super high after winning his 6th driver's title and was struggling to come to terms with his achievement. The British Mercedes driver clinched the championship with 2nd place at the United States Grand Prix behind teammate Valtteri Bottas on Sunday. Hamilton said he was not able to comprehend the scale of his achievement, which moves him to within reach of Michael Schumacher's all-time record of 7 world championships. This further confirms his position as one of the greatest in Formula One history and places him as one of the greatest British athletes. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International Trucks and Parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand, SKF bearings and mounted products, Napa batteries, Tide power generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc., the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back, you're still at MTV's News Update. Now for some news in the region. Venezuela has expelled El Salvador diplomats in a tit-for-tat response after El Salvador on Saturday told Venezuelan diplomats to leave. The El Salvadorians have 48 hours to leave the country. El Salvador's government does not recognize Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro as legitimate. It said it would receive a new Venezuelan diplomatic team that represented the country's opposition leader Juan Guaido. Mr. Maduro and Mr. Guaido, leader of the opposition-controlled National Assembly, are embroiled in a power struggle. Mr. Guaido declared himself interim president in January, saying that the elections which brought Mr. Maduro to power for a 2nd term were fraudulent. On the international scene, a recalled U.S. ambassador at the center of the Trump impeachment inquiry said she felt threatened by a cryptic remark the president made about her on a call. Ex-envoy to Ukraine Maria Yovankovich told Congress she was, quote, very concerned, end quote, by President Donald Trump's comment in the phone call with Ukraine's leader. Mr. Trump told his counterpart, well, she, Mr. Yovankovich, going to go through some things. Democrats have just released the first transcripts from closed-door testimony. The Republican president is accused of trying to pressure Ukraine into investigating unsubstantiated corruption claims against his U.S. political rival Joe Biden and his son Hunter Biden, who work with a Ukrainian gas company. Ms. Yovanovitch said she was shocked by what the president said about her in a July 25 phone call with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. That call triggered a current congressional impeachment investigation that could seek to remove Mr. Trump from office for alleged abuses of power. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:50. Let's now turn our attention to the Demar Harbor Bridge and the Burbies River Bridge schedules. This is where we'll wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Heightened your activism, return home and vote in March 2020, Jagdeo tells large gathering of Guyanese in Canada. GCAM staff accused of turning away persons from registration offices. Businessman shoots bandage in home invasion as crime continues to spiral. 17 murders in just 2 weeks, but top cop unbothered about crime situation. And in sport, West Indies not taken Afghanistan lightly ahead of first ODI on Wednesday. Qatar rebroadcast it 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Have a good night.